Before we start today's walk down, I'd like us to pay our respects to Her Majesty. She-Hulk, the Queen of Woke, usurped in the top of the wokes by the Rings of Power. After holding the number one spot for so long, it's been knocked off its bloody woke perch with one brutal Bezos body blow. Can She-Hulk achieve Mission Impossible and reclaim her throne from Bezos Power Ranger Princess? There's only one way to find out. Here's the full woke down for episode 4 of She-Woke, Attorney at War with Men, with Rich Bald White Men. She-Hulk starts like it always starts, with you wanting to gouge your eyes out. Why do we have these recaps? It's hard enough getting through one bloody episode. Why make us watch it again? They should be playing She-Hulk to prevent crime like in Clockwork Orange. Be like Batman just moved in the house next door. Your street would be emptier than Kim Jong-un's. This Magic Mike pops on screen and he asks for a volunteer from the audience. For some reason, this woman is the only one who puts her hand up. I thought the whole point of the show was to show women are weak and feeble, dominated by sexist arseholes. Why is some misogynist not telling her to sit down? You're drunk, woman! How did that not come up in the woke brainstorm session? The audience looks like they just left the first She-Hulk test screening, but I'm not sure why. The birdie weirdie was literally levitating and lighting cigs from his bleeding fingertips. If I did that down my local pub, I'd never have to buy a round again. I'd probably have those scientists from ET chasing after me as well. Talk about a tough crowd. Need to bring in the She-Hulk Rotten Tomatoes reviewers. They'll clap like seals without even watching the show. So a lady volunteer steps up, but she hams up her ditzy-dumb personality to the nth degree. You'd think she's auditioning for a Legally Blonde musical, but it's so over the top, you end up thinking she's legally brain-dead. By the way, has Morgan Freeman fallen on hard times? Can someone set up a GoFundMe? If he's in this, he might as well go back to Shawshank. Red doesn't want to be here, mate. What's this magic fella's big trick then? Shitting in a glass box for a week? Doing a second coming on the River Thames? Banging a woman half his age? No, his grand reveal is shooting a woman through an hole into the lap of a flaccid Wang. Well, he don't stay flaccid for long. Wang shoots up like a rocket at the first sight of this hot mess. On Wang's TV, you can see he was watching The Sopranos. Can we watch that instead? Hold on, I'll ask Mrs. Oh wait, Legally Brain Dead goes on to spoil that show as well. Drop some massive spoilers about who dies. Cheers, love. I was hoping to watch that. Gonna flog the box set of the car boot now. Wonder if another TV show will ever have She-Hulk playing in background. At least you wouldn't be able to spoil it. It'd just be shitting on shit, wouldn't it? Nearly 5 minutes in and we see She-Hulk. It's all downhill from here, lads and lasses. She breaks the fourth wall and I feel like breaking my telly. She says, you look happy. Well, I was, love, until about 5 minutes ago. Then she says, everyone loves Wang and his cameos give her show Twitter armor for a week. If you cared more about your viewers instead of the Twitterati, you might have more than just me and my nana watching. Have you ever seen a show where the main character knows that their own show is shit? This should have been Wang's show. Ticks all the right boxes, but he's got substance, some character, some style. She's more vacuous than a brand new vacuum cleaner. It turns out She-Hulk's dad is a plumber.
It's me, Mario!
No idea why he's here though. Men are not allowed to rescue princesses anymore. Princesses rescue them. He's brought around a load of security gear, because in the last episode she got jumped by a gang of thugs. Why did he bother? She Kevin McAllister'd them, like they were Ari and Marv from Home Alone. Are the writers saying that a woman built like a brick shithouse, a green god, who can withstand a nuclear blast, needs pepper spray? Who's coming to attack her? Superman? Justice League? Speaking of Home Alone, She-Hulk's in her office and we get a good look at a to-do list. Nothing you expect comes up. She's gone online dating. When she hit that activate account button, I thought, I know the perfect match.
Oh, hello there!
She already thinks all men are ogres, so why not a proper one? She-Hulk even has an uncanny resemblance with his wife. Get those divorce papers out, big lad, and join the Marvel Universe. You'll be the most normal bloke on this show by a country mile. Her best mate walks in and tells She-Hulk to buy some new clothes. Not very progressive there, love. I thought it was just a stereotype that women love clothes shopping. It's such a stereotype that I barely have enough to eat after my missus has been on High Street for 10 minutes. Here we go again. Groundhog Day. Where's Bill Murray? She-Hulk gets triggered by a nickname on TV. She says she only has that name because of ding-dongs. Is it really that upsetting to have a badass nickname like She-Hulk? Well, it was badass until your Marty ass started shedding tears over it. Jesus wept. Wang pops up and complains about an air quotes magician. That's how I refer to She-Hulk. She is a stunning and brave superhero. Or is that superheroine? Or superperson? Good job I'm not on Twitter these days. Wang wants to stop him doing unlicensed magic. So rather than call the Avengers or Doctor Strange, he rocks up to She-Hulk's office to solve it in court. Yeah, that'll show him. She-Hulk goes for a drink down a local with her best mate. You know, the pub where every week she starts monologuing and you feel like you're on an airplane. They're setting up her online dating profile. I wish I had online dating when I met my missus. I had to down 10 pints to walk over and get her number, and I still ended up looking like Don Knotts. Before they can even get the profile pick up, She-Hulk morphs into the usual suspects. But instead of master career criminals and Kaiser Soze, we get master misogynistic bigots and Kaiser Sleazy. The usual sexists. The show becomes a lineup of the most over-the-top sexist arseholes all competing to win the Sexist Arsehole Olympics. As luck would have it, they all swipe right on She-Hulk and they all line up to date her one by one. The first lucky contestant is this bloke. He goes the old-fashioned route. He goes full 20th century and walks over to actually talk to him. No dating app required. You'd think such courage in 2022 would be rewarded. He calls She-Hulk stunning. For some reason, he forgets the brave part. He offers to buy these two sexy ladies a drink. What a bastard. They say they're working, but he's smoother than silk underpants. He says if they change their minds, he's at the bar. Not bad, but then he commits the cardinal sin established with Dennis the misogynistic menace in the last episode, the wink. Oh shit, could you be any more of a sexist arsehole, mate? She-Hulk says, that guy is exactly why I don't date, and you're exactly why no one watches She-Hulk. Poor bloke. It takes balls to walk over to a woman, and he gets slapped down harder than Chris Rock. Next up is this unlucky lad. You can tell he's an arsehole already, just from the haircut. What the fuck is that? Reminds me of that scene in Liar Liar.
I don't know whether to comb it or scrape it out with a shovel and bury it in lime!
Within about 15 seconds, he's already checking out other chicks. Although, to be fair to him, they would be a massive upgrade. He asks what She-Hulk does, but he looks like me watching Loose Women. Blatantly ignoring her. I tried standing up to applaud when he did, but the missus shot me down. She-Hulk then drops she has superpowers, but he's 10 times more interested in his phone. Yeah, we know, mate. The lad does a smart thing and Clark Kents himself out of there without even picking up the bill. He even calls her a 6 out of 10 on the way out. A bit generous there, mate. She-Hulk gives up trying to attract a bloke with her personality, so turns to catfishing, changes her online profile pic into the mean green feminist fighting machine. The matches come rolling in. Although I think half of them are blokes swiping right by accident. Must think the colour settings have gone apeshit on their phone. Contestant number 3 calls She-Hulk stunning as well. I'm starting to think the writers have lost their thesaurus. Why are they all calling her stunning? Is that the buzzword to compliment women nowadays? I'll try it on the missus tonight, might get a bit of action for once. Her smile reminds me of a rabbit.
What's up, Doc?
She-Hulk doesn't need much chatting up. She's won over by his looks in half a second. Inspirational stuff. Judge a bloke by his looks. Fingers crossed they don't mind when a bloke judges a woman by hers. Whoa, massive faux pas there, mate. We want strong women, not strong men. Next. Number 4 talks politics. Next. Number 5 talks like a top critic on Rotten Tomatoes. Your battle with Titania in court was incredible. God, you're just so powerful. What a specimen. What did you just say? Did you just call She-Hulk a specimen? How dare you? We say specy women now, you sexist pig. Out! She-Hulk talks to us and asks, is there anything worse than dating in your 30s? I can think of several things, love, and they all involve She-Hulk. Wait, this bloke looks promising. Handsome chap. How's his personality? Well, he's a doctor. Forget the date, just go straight for the drive-thru. All a woman needs is an handsome man with a nice job, right? Then he refuses to talk. He wants to listen to She-Hulk stories. They end up back at her apartment faster than it takes Ezra Miller to elude the cops. What an empathetic listener. Wow, I can totally see how your boss springing that on you on the first day would make you spiral. Tell me more about how you felt. Now this is a true man, everyone. The way he talks is how I sound when I try to mock my wife in an argument. Let's talk about our feelings. Well, at least She-Hulk finally has a decent bloke, albeit one who's Women's Digest masturbation material. Their Netflix and chill time is interrupted by Wang. No, not is. The Wang. The Sorcerer Supremo needs She-Hulk to save the day. Johnny Blaze opened up a portal and Gizmo came through, followed by Gremlins. Wonder how many calls Wang made before going down the list to She-Hulk. Even though people are possibly being viciously ripped limb from limb by these flying gremlins, She-Hulk makes time to make googly eyes at Mr. Estrogen. This lass knows her priorities. She throws the little bastards around like the Play-Doh. I remember when superheroes, even proper ones, face some kind of danger on TV. This is like watching your little brother beat the shit out of goons in Ratchet and Clank on easy mode. Isn't drama supposed to be, you know, dramatic? Wang plugs his old and clicks his fingers, and all the demon spawn go from whence they came. Mate, why don't you just do that at the beginning? You didn't even need She-Hulk. No one does. She just came in to show how stunning she is, and you did all the work. She-Hulk knows the only true way to make a man do what you want is to threaten him. Misogynist Merlin agrees to stop using real magic, or he'd have been torn apart like a bear in prey. Not much of a choice to make there, mate. For all the talk about this being a legal drama show, she only solves this case by threatening a gruesome death. Quality work, attorney at law. She's back home with Romeo, you know, the one who acts like Juliet. What's that book he's reading? Bad what? Bad feminist? You couldn't make this up now. He's a stone's throw away from getting a sex change completely. The bloke is a literal woman in all but the downstairs department. And the writers say men are either massive sexist arseholes or wangless wankers. Looks like it. She can't see him off to the bedroom like he needs his nappy changed. The Heaven is a Place on Earth song is playing. She-Hulk is in paradise. Romantic bliss. The mass murdering ginger spice Titania comes on the TV, let out on a technicality. For some reason, they're still calling her a super-powered influencer, even though it's already been established she's basically the Yorkshire Ripper. Oh shit, the Wangless Wonder walks out. The gig is up, She-Hulk. Your catfishing, Hulk-fishing days are over. Like all blokes tricked into the bedroom, ease out of there faster than a married man leaving a massage parlour. Poor She-Hulk. She tells us hot doctors are a cliche anyway. Never mind, there's a knock at the door. Is this the man she's been looking for her whole life? Michael Moore? Is he doing another sicko documentary? Most dramatic moment in She-Hulk yet. She finds out Titanic is suing her over the use of the She-Hulk trademark. What a cliffhanger. 24's got nothing on this, has it? I won't be able to sleep all week waiting to find out if She-Hulk wins her trade dispute. Post-credit scene. Oh, my missus won't have to bring out the bucket and mop this time. Nothing at all happens. No, literally nothing. It's just Ott Mess and his wangness watching TV shows we wish we were watching. I guess post-credit scenes now are the ones that used to be put in the deleted scenes bin. So did She-Woke get her woke crown back? Has Rings of Power been kicked out of power? Top of the wokes again? Bad news, She-Woke. You've gone backwards, love. I can only give this episode an 8 out of 10 woke rating. We had the usual sexists, a bloke from Venus, and legally brain dead, but we needed a proper rant against sexist arseholes like in the previous episodes. He's just not good enough. Must try harder for real Twitter woke brownie points. Fingers crossed next week as She-Hulk back to a fighting men form. Come on, She-Hulk, we're not giving up on you just yet. Love dissecting woke films and shows. Watch me go through all of them like the dead woke frogs they are. Please click like and subscribe. Cheers a lot.